بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. Dear viewers, brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We're all grateful that we have this opportunity once again to discuss the holy verses of Quran and the narrations of Ahl Bayt alayhim as-salam, and asking by the blessing of this holy land and of Karbala and the shrines of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and Abul Fadl Abbas alayhi salam, to have the honor of bringing the teachings of Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam into our lives, and by that attaining closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have followed us, we have reached the sixth verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, where we discussed the beginning of it, and inshallah we continue more. The verse states, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. As for the faithless, it is same to them. Whether you warn them or do not warn them, they will not have faith. So we discussed about pious individuals and their characteristics. We are transferring to disbelievers, faithless, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, doesn't matter if you warn them or you don't warn them, they will not have faith. So, we started talking about kufr. What is disbelief? We got to a beautiful hadith by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, which is in the book of Al-Kafi al-Sharif, Noble Kafi, where a person came and asked the Imam, just reminding ourselves, asked the Imam, what are different kinds of disbelief within the Holy Quran? Imam says there are five kinds of disbelief within the Holy Quran. Imam listed them. We mentioned the first, and we're going to the second. Imam says, "Ala khamsat awjuh." There are five kinds: kufr al juhud wa juhud ala wajhain. Denial. That's the first. Basically, denying in Allah, denying Allah's existence of Allah subhanahu wa taala, justice of Allah subhanahu wa taala, attributes of Allah subhanahu wa taala, and Rasulullah, Holy Quran, heaven, hell, reward, punishment, all denying. That's the first level, first kind of disbelief, which has its two, which we'll discuss it. وَالْكُفْرْ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ. Disbelief, this is which we, some of the Muslims, some of us, we might fall into this category. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the verse, by the blessing and the grace of the holy verse of Quran and the narrative of Ahl Bayt alayhim salam, if it applies for us, that inshallah from tonight, from this episode, from this moment, we work on completely eradicating, cleansing our heart from this disbelief. وَالْكُفْرْ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ. Disbelieving in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. We discussed this within the previous verses. We elaborate a little bit more. As we mentioned, the Holy Quran, the teachings of the Holy Quran, and the narrations of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam, they all together, the religion of Islam, to be three elements that makes the religion of Islam. We discussed this many times. Number one, aqeedah, believe, the fundamentals, tawheed, oneness of Allah, adalah, justice of Allah, nubuwwah, prophethood, imamah, 12 disciples of the Holy Prophet, and Qiyam. This is our belief. This is our foundation of our belief. Usul al-Din. And then comes Ahkam, jurisprudence, 10 furu' al-Din. Salah, Zakat, Khums, Hajj, Jihad, encouraging good, discouraging evil, fasting, loving Ahl Bayt, and hating their enemies. These are furu' al-Din. These are the branches. These need practice. In here, Imam says there's another kind of kufr, and that is وَالْكُفْرُ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ. I'll take from, for example, from these 10, I'll take 5 that I have been commanded. I act upon it. I'll do it. By the other 5, I leave it aside. I don't believe in them. I don't think that is that they are necessary. I remember one of the people that I was interviewing for a documentary about the revert life. I asked her, how did you approach Islam? How did you approach the teachings of Muhammad and Al Muhammad? She said, I did not approach it with the mindset of cafeteria. I was kind of amazed as an example, an analogy, and trying to kind of confuse what is she trying to tell me. She said, when we get to cafeteria, if you have seen, like for example, within our schools, high schools, or some open buffet you go, you take your tray and you have your plates, you go and you go through different dishes. You like some, you take. You don't like some, you don't take. She said, I didn't look at the religion of Islam and the teachings of Quran and Muhammad and Ali Muhammad, and I didn't approach it within a cafeteria mindset. No. When I came to the religion of Islam, I took it as a whole complete package. It was a sister that I interviewed. She said, hijab is part of it. Not listening to music is part of it. Haram and halal, consuming of halal and haram is part of it. Salah is part of it. Purities and impurities, najasat and taharat is part of it. Khums and zakat, it's part of it. Giving charity is part of it. Salah is part of it. Good akhlaq, which is the third one, ahkam, and then akhlaq, it is part of it. So we have to take complete of the religion. Some people, when it comes to salah, beautiful, on time. Recitation of Quran, on time. And ahkam, all the ahkam, the believers, they have a complete faith, inshallah. Ahkam, complete ahkam. But when it comes to their akhlaq, to their demeanor, to their morality, they're lacking. They're behind. Gossiping, it's there, which is haram, forbidden. Lying is there. Their salah is there, but they gossip. Their salah is there, but their hijab is not proper hijab. Proper hijab, according to the teachings of Islam, according to the teachings of Muhammad and Al Muhammad, may Allah bless them. Salawatullah alayhim ajma'in. Not according to our culture, because some culture, unfortunately, throughout my journey within different states, different provinces, different communities, for some communities, hijab is not part of their deen, their belief. They believe in Imams of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam. They believe in Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha. When the time of commemoration comes for the martyrdom of Lady Fatima al-Zahra, they will shed tears and they will mourn and they will participate in the rituals of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein. But Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam, Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha, then let's look at her life and the way hijab was described as Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha mentioned within our ahadith. What is the hijab of Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha? Is it only for her, or is it for you and I as a woman that we have to also follow? Brothers, salah is there on time. Hajj, mashallah, 6-7 times have been to Hajj. And Saum, all of their fasting is done. But when it comes to khums, when it comes times of giving money, 1/5, which is not his money, we have to come to this understanding that 1/5 of our money, with all the fatawis, with all the rulings, I'm just giving a brief, it's not ours that we must concern. Where does it go? How does it spend? It's not our money. That money must be given to the representative of the imam of our time, and this is it. It's been removed from our shoulder. It is someone else's responsibility, because we are not the representative of the imams. Our maraja al-taqlid, may Allah bless them all, they are the representative of the imams. We don't have one representative of the imam. No, there are many. During the time of the minor occultation, there were 4, one after one, which they were appointed by the imam himself. The first one was appointed, and then the first one said that the second one, and the second one, third, and the third, and fourth. After the fourth representative of the imam during his minor occultation, and when the major occultation, greater occultation started, the imam said, well, I don't have specific one. Maraja al-taqlid, ulama, those who have characteristics that imam have said, they are my representative. They are Allah's proof upon the people, and I'm Allah's proof upon them. So we give it to them. So khums, imam says, وَالْكُفْرُ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ. Another kind of kufr. We said, imam said 5 within the Holy Quran. There are 5 kinds of kufr. 1, complete denial, which has 2, which we will get to the detail of it when we get to the rest of hadith. The other is, وَالْكُفْرُ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ. Allah has said music is haram, as his command, within the Holy Quran, verses of Quran, and the narrations of Ahl Bayt alayhi salam, and fatawi of majority of our maraja, more than 98% of the maraja. The typical music that we know of it. Well, I do my salah, I do my zakat, I do my khums, I've been to hajj, I have hijab, but when it comes to music, I can't resist. I can't stop listening to it. And any other commands that we have been commanded. Anger, temper issues. Makaram al-akhlaq, akhlaq, morality, morality, morality. Very, very important. Faith is there, as we mentioned. Aqidah is there, jurisprudence is there. But when it comes to morality, it doesn't at all matches with the teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. When we hear somebody have said something about us or comes and insults us to our face, we make sure we pay them back. Not remembering the hadith and the narrations and the stories of the life of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam, where a person comes, you've heard this, it's a beautiful story many times, person comes to Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam and calls him, address him and tells him, Na'udhu billah, you are Baqara. You know, Baqara. If you remove Alif, which is Baqir, becomes Baqara, means cow. He's telling Imam, Allah's representative on earth, Khalifatullah, infallible ma'soom on earth, he calls him a cow. Imam tells him, no, I am Baqir. Khalas. Or with another story, a person comes to Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam from Sham, where he was brainwashed by Muawiyah. He comes to Sham, comes to Medina. He sees Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam with his companions. He finds that he's Imam Hassan. He comes and he insults Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib to his face, to the face of Imam Hassan. He curses his father and he curses Imam Hassan. And then Imam tells him, it shows that you're a stranger. Stranger. Imam tells him, if you are thirsty, we will water you. We'll give you water. If you're hungry, we will feed you. If you don't have clothes, we will clothe you. If you don't have a ride, we will give you ride. If you don't have a place to stay, we will make you to stay in our place. The person says, well, I'm sorry, I was brainwashed. I was completely misguided. He becomes the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. So us studying the lives of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, studying Quran, both of them together, so we make sure this kind of kufr doesn't apply to us. That becomes a very important action plan. That I go tonight, I see which part of religion, when I heard of it, between wife and husband relationship. My wife says something, my husband says something. Is this part of my rights and responsibility or not? If this is part of my rights and responsibility, if I don't apply, if I don't act upon it, وَالْكُفْرُ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ Allah has commanded me, as a wife, I have some rights and responsibility toward my husband. I, as a husband, I have some rights and responsibility toward my wife. As a parents, we have some rights and responsibility to our kids. As a kids, children, we have rights and responsibility to our parents. That we must not raise our voice, we must be obedient, we must treat them with kindness, and so on and so forth. That is within the teachings of Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. We have to be very careful. This segment of this kind of kufr can be, unfortunately, we have to say, can be, C-A-N, can be applied to many Muslims. When it comes to some Muslims, some majority of the Muslims, believing Allah is there. Believing in Rasulullah is there. Believing in the Quran is there. But when it comes to the commander of the faithful, wilayah of Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, to be the Khalifa right away after Rasulullah, where he appoints him within the day of Ghadir, Khum, Eid al-Ghadir, that we have greatest aid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they short. They don't have the wilayah of Ahlul Bayt. They pray all their prayers. They fast all of their fastings. Hijab perfectly. Quran recitation perfectly. Everything is perfect. When it comes to wilayah is missing. And we have within the verses of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, if the wilayah is not there, they're missing. That key, that chain, it's like chain of sabha, tasbih, rosary. It's a complete package of five usul ad-deen, furu ad-deen, branches, and moralities. That's what makes us Islam. So we make sure we know of them all. And as we go more and more, we read more and we apply more, inshallah, again, so this segment of hadith doesn't apply to us. وَالْكُفْرُ بِتَرْكِ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهِ We hope this kind of kufr does not apply to us. وَكُفْرُ الْبَرَاءَةِ Another disbelief is when we disassociate from something, which we'll discuss. وَكُفْرُ النِّعَمِ When we do not appreciate and we are not grateful of Allah's bounties and boons and blessing that He has upon us. So Imam first gives the listing and then right now he explains. فَأَمَّا كُفْرُ الْجُحُودِ فَهُوَ الْجُحُودُ بِالرَّبُوبِيَّةِ When you kufr, remember it said five kinds, we discussed about the five, we mentioned them, we explained it a bit. Right now Imam goes and explains them in detail. Inshallah, we have couple of minutes, we'll discuss some part of it and then we leave the next for the next episode. وَالْجُحُودِ فَأَمَّا الْكُفْرُ الْجُحُودِ denial, the kufr of denial, فهو الجحود بالربوبية, denying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهو قول من يقول لا رب ولا جنة ولا نار. Those people who say there is no heaven, no hell, no God. وهو قول الصنفين من الزنادقة. This is from the kuffar, disbelievers. And we discussed that. And it's only guess. They guess. This, their argument that there is no God, that there is no heaven or hell, it doesn't have any rational base. It doesn't have any logical, they don't have any logical argument. It's only a theory. They cannot prove it, that doesn't exist. And then, so these people, the verse of the Holy Quran that we say, أَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, it applies to these people. That they completely deny the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Deny heaven, hell, day of judgment, and everything that has to do with divine. This verse applies to these first group. How about the next four group? Inshallah, we discuss it in the next episode. Inshallah, let us conclude asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the blessing of these verses of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam and the shrines of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam, Imam Mahdi ajalallahu ta'ala farajah sharif, which is the most important dua that we always have to remember, and we have to pray for his reappearance abundantly. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنوا أرضك طوعا وتمتعوا فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.